Sky has rated the following film 15.
Imagine the scene. Just moving to the Great British Colony of Low Canada, you're ready to start your new life. Kick out the French and make a real change. This right here is Louis Joseph Poppadine.
My spidey senses tell me this is gonna get tasty.
As you can see, just like the X-Men says, but there was still hope. One man against the odds, thrust into strange new land with the sole aim of calming all this down. You know him. You love him. You might even have slept with him. It's the legendary ladies' man.
The robust reporter.
The never drinker.
It's Durham, ladies and gentlemen.
Darren only had one thing on his mind when he stepped off that boat. Figure out what in the hell made everybody lose their bloody mind. Well, both Canada's still, apparently, well and truly losing their minds. And Darren saw that. So, he went to work not actually fixing anything, just looking around to think about how could he fix it. Today. Oh, good to see you. Now let me just say, Durham then proposed would be something so radical, drastic, and incomprehensible that it would shock the British government to their core. Let the Canadas have their own government. Are you serious? Oh, fancy seeing you here. Now, a wind down from this radicality was a more appealing idea for the British to get their governments around. Unified Canada's. You can follow me, please. By looking at this crucial drawing, you can see quite clearly that Upper Canada, located in the south, was actually separate from Lower Canada, located in the north. Unifying them and letting them govern themselves to an extent would surely help the situation. Durham also looked a bit further north to Nova Scotia and also New Brunswick, but a little too far for the British, aren't they? Now, unifying Canada's would also fix another problem that the British ran into quite a bit in their empire days, ethnicity. As with British history and modernity, England f***ing hated the French, and the same was true in Canada. The English hated the French because they wore silly hats and they made weird-shaped bread. As you can see in this totally beautiful, snowy area, and look how populated it is.
Fuck off.
Lovely people, right?
Now, the French hated them too, equally, because they were bigger within them and they invented football. As Durham loved football and was from England himself, he decided that the French could suck it up and if they didn't like that, they could go back to where they came from. Now, just as an FYI, I've been informed by my trustworthy advisories that this is one of the safest areas in the beautiful Canadian region. So, it's going to be lovely to see how beautiful and safe this area is. Back to what I was saying. Durham also decided that the family compact had to go. He had decided that they were not suitable for Canada and they could just, like the French, go back to where they came from. Although, where they came from was also a bit obscure. Anyways, this brings us back to that radical matter mentioned earlier. Durham realised that the government back in London wouldn't like the idea of Canada making its own decisions. So, he decided that they could make a few decisions on domestic matters. And this would please the government, as they agreed on Durham's advice. In 1840s, the Canadas were united, and the French Canadians deemed to be just Canadian. They also granted a government too. As you can see, the people are thrilled. I'm sure this relationship is going to last forever.